Now, okay. Now, can we come back to the point? The point here is, Tanveer Sadiq, I want you to respond to Smriti Irani. She's making some serious allegations. She is saying there. And the question here is, how is it that Rahul Gandhi knows that the ISI is in contact with the affected youth in Muzaffarnagar? And the additional Director General of Law and Order, Mukul Goyal, in Uttar Pradesh doesn't? You know, this is all happening in a backdrop of what is being seen to be an attempt by Rahul Gandhi to push the communal versus secular debate. May I have your response to Smriti Irani and to Asifa Khan?
Now, first of all, I can't speak on Rahul Gandhi. I mean, I'm sure the Congress spokesman will speak on behalf of him. But here, because the debate is on Mr. Kalbe Sadiq and then what happened when about that ISI debate. Now, first of all, I'll talk about Smriti Irani. I don't know where she was going when she spoke about Jawaharlal Nehruji and Rahul Gandhi came here and met Pandits. I don't know where she gets all this information from. Now, number two, very important is that out of 1.27 billion Muslims, I'll go ahead with what Mr. Kamal is saying, that 177 million are Muslims, and I don't feel that Mr. Kalbe Sadiq represents all of them. But having that being said, I believe that...
Does he represent some of them in your view?
His own speech. Okay, fair enough. I mean, with all due respect to him, he may not. The point is that today, he even in his speech said that, first of all, Modi should apologize. I mean, he should apologize. In that case, I think any secular Indian, whether he's Muslim or Hindu, everybody knows that nobody can forget what happened in 2002. And I believe not only it brought a bad name to the country, but also to our secular, it broke our secular fabric here. Now, my point is that he should first resign, and then we can talk about, when the bridge comes, we'll think of talking about it. But today I feel that even though if you learn from your experiences, Mr. Narendra Modi is on record saying that he is a Hindu nationalist. He is one of his, Mr. Subramaniam Swamy says, divide Muslims and unite Hindus. Uma Bharti after Muzaffarnagar riots comes out and that's sadly Prachi.
Asifa wants to counter you. Asifa, 1 minute.
A certain community. My point is,
Asifa will counter next.
I don't think any Muslim will forget what happened in 2002.
No, if you are talking about 2002, Asifa, is it you there who wants to counter?
No, Smriti.
That's Smriti. Smriti wants to counter. No, Smriti and Asifa, to you, both of you. First, Smriti, you want to counter, that's fine. I just want to welcome Zafar Sareshwala into the debate here right now. I found it interesting that Modi called on Rahul Gandhi to apologize for casting aspersions on the loyalty of Muslims. Did he deliberately stop short of asking Rahul to apologize for 1984? Because if he had asked Rahul to apologize for 1984, that would have invited calls for Modi to apologize, Asifa, for the riots of 2002. Am I correct? He's playing safe.
Arnab, in the first place, Muzaffarnagar is just 70 kilometers away from Delhi. And Muzaffarnagar, as you and me know, was simmering for a week. And why did the Congress not go there earlier and look into the situation? The Congress in its history always waits for around 100 Muslims to be killed and about 1,000 Muslims to go
to refugee
camps.
There?
And then they come out of their comfort zone for a photo opportunity. And when there are panelists on the from the Congress today telling that why didn't we say sorry and why does the sorry issue comes up, Modi is not going to come and say sorry to Mr. Gohil. Modi has showed it in his action. Any leader of this country will be judged by his deeds and not by his words. And Modi has spoken
to a
number of delegations, Muslims visiting to him. And what did you do, Mr. Gohil? You didn't go to Bhavnagar to save the children. Why did you lose in your own constituency? The Muslims didn't vote for you. Why are you out of power for the last 22 years?
Go ahead, Mr. Gohil is countering. After that, Zafar Sareshwala is responding. Mr. Gohil, please. Mr. Gohil, please.
Dominated area.
Okay, limited time. Mr. Gohil is going next. Mr. Gohil.
Why is there...
You asked a number of questions. Let him respond, please. Mr. Gohil.
Of this country, and there are thousands of
1 minute, Asifa. Asifa, let him respond to you, please.
Let us stop.
You are doing nothing for them.
Let him respond to you, please, Mr. Gohil.
Arnab, on your challenge, this is my openly. I am telling you, and this is a challenge. I have a long political experience. I leave my politics if it is proved, I will come with the data on your challenge. Asifa, I have a high respect for her. I know Modi must have given her a brief without the.
No, no.
I will come with the data of my constituency. When there was a riots, I was moving in my constituency.
Mr. Goyal, you don't speak.
I was moving in my constituency. I was at midnight. I will request.
Do not bring up.
I will request. In Bhavnagar, I was there very much there. And in all the Muslim areas, Muslims voted and even secular Hindus voted for me for 90% votes. I was in my constituency.
Mr. Gohil,
open challenge.
Mr. Gohil, you can give a challenge, but others have a right to counter you, right? So, Zafar Sareshwala, please. Yes, Mr. Sareshwala, this is...
Satal Jafar has a... Jafar, I don't want to speak anything personal about anyone. But when there is a personal attack,
Mr. Gohil,
what
you don't speak about Muslims. Mr. Gohil, you dare not talk about Muslims. Your face is tainted.
What are you talking?
You have brought in Congress Party the discarded of VHP and Bajrang Dal. You talk about your leader, Mr. Shankar Singh Waghela. Where was even Babri Masjid?
What are you talking, Jafar Sareshwala? I am not a fraud who is coming from London and having a shelter from Modi, having a blessing for Adani and on Adani's money. I am not saying that. I don't have any complaint against me.
Don't talk
what
nonsense.
Are you, Jafar Sareshwala? I am not anyone on play role.
Talk about the debate.
Come with me in Bhavnagar. We'll go in Muslim
That's
areas.
That's why people have defeated you in Bhavnagar. You dare
tell
not
you the
come
truth.
Out and talk about Muslims at all.
Let the Muslims of Bhavnagar tell you on your face.
You befitting
without
reply.
Any security, without anyone.
You
I am ready to come in my area. In a Muslim area. And let the Muslims of Gujarat tell you what Shankar Singh Goyal has done for Muslims.
Out.
And you are on a payroll. I can
areas.
Understand. From
you,
London,
you
why you are in Gujarat.
Okay, this discussion now I'm coming in, please.
We know it. We are concerned about the mass. We don't have any personal agenda, Mr. Jafar Sareshwala, like you.
Mr. Gohil,
One minute.
There is a petition against you in the High Court. What are the allegations against you?
May I please, Mr. Gohil, again for a second time, you are going personal on the debate. Mr. Gohil, for a second time, you are going personal on the debate. I request you, don't make it personal. You know, let's discuss. They want to discuss.
No, because he has started.
They want to discuss.
If someone will start, I will go and I will tell them. If someone will go personal, if I am a tinted, let the channel, let him
but
come
it
and
won't
show
help
the
debate.
Picture.
1 minute.
I am ready to go with him in my area.
One of the reasons. May I please go back to Smriti Rani? 1 minute. Smriti Rani, you are still there?
If someone will start personal,
Smriti Rani,
to listen.
Yes.
Smriti Rani.
Yes.
Tell me, and let's not, don't respond to exact, the point is the BJP trying hard to get the individual support of individual members, senior representatives of... We have your video, by the way. Thank God your video line is finally back. Is the BJP trying hard to get concurrence of its views or some endorsement for it from members of the Muslim community? Is there some effort that is going on to get concurrence from certain members of the Muslim community? Because people are drawing those links and inferences.
Extremely.
Yes.
No, I think... It would be extremely...
Go ahead, we can hear you. Carry on. We can hear you.
Hello?
We can hear you. Carry on. We're going to dial her again. Hassan Kamal, what do you think on that? 1 second, gentlemen. I go to Hassan Kamal, please. 1 second, Mr. Sareshwala. Hassan Kamal? The support that is coming in from some people, it's not doctored for sure. Yeah.
Number one, I'm not ready to participate in a screaming match, but I will tell you one thing. It is a constant effort by BJP and now by Mr. Modi also to have some contact with some Muslims. Well, Mr. Zafar Sareshwala is already there. Some more Muslims like him.
No, Mr.
To
Hassan
show
Kamal,
the rest
don't
of the
go
world,
personal. Mr. Hassan Kamal. Don't go personal.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Talk about the topic.
Okay.
Don't go personal, Mr. Hassan.
Okay.
Please. No, but remain in the decorum of the debate.
Don't scream.
No, Mr. Hassan Kamal, it does not defeat people like you to go personal. This is very, very unparliamentary.
Okay, now, Mr. Sareshwala, let him complete. Mr. Sareshwala, let him complete. He's making his point. You may not agree with it. He has a right to make the point, Mr. Sareshwala, with I request you. He has a right to make his point.
No, no, but he has no right. He has no right to go personal.
Mr. Sareshwala, I request you, let him complete his point. And the whole business of a news hour debate is, even if you totally violently disagree with the other person's point of view, in the interest of having an open debate, let's be frank. Otherwise, we shouldn't have the news hour debate.
There is some decorum.
I understand.
No, Mr. Hasan Kamal, this is absolutely unparliamentary on your part to take people's names.
So keep
No, don't take names. Don't take names.
Keep quiet for a minute.
Let him
keep quiet. Don't scream. Keep quiet for a minute. I know you don't want to listen.
No, I'm only
1 minute now, Mr. Sareshwala. I'm giving you one warning. Please, Mr. Sareshwala. Please. Let him complete.
Again, you are interrupting. You don't want to listen. So, Mr. Modi now and BJP from quite some time is trying to contact certain Muslims to show the rest of the world that at least a part of the Muslims with him. It's like they have got every right to do that. But asking some clerics to speak on their behalf or asking some big businessmen to speak on their behalf doesn't mean that the entire community is with him or with BJP. We have got the complete political record of BJP since 1992. And we have got a complete political record of Mr. Narendra Modi from 2002 and on. So we don't have to be convinced by some clerics or some big businessmen that Muslims...
Okay, now Hasan Kamal...
And nobody's...
Now Hasan Kamal, you made your point. Now I want you to listen to the counter from Smriti Irani. Smriti Irani, the final point is this. And you can respond in detail.
Sure.
Mr. Hasan Kamal makes a fairly straightforward accusation. He says there is a constant effort by the BJP and Narendra Modi and his supporters to have contact with some Muslims. In other words, he's saying this support, whatever support is coming, is not natural. He's suggesting that a lot of it is orchestrated. Respond directly to him tonight before I close the debate.
I think it's quite preposterous that Mr. Hasan Kamal thinks that Muslim clerics are up for sale in Indian polity. I think it is quite preposterous for him to attribute political motive to any Indian, irrespective of his religion, Hindu or Muslim, who speaks in favor of development. While Mr. Hasan Kamal is trying to hear ascertain that dal mein kuch kala hai, let me very humbly submit to him that every Indian who speaks or aspires for a developed nation need not be looked upon, Mr. Hasan Kamal, from a communal eye. They are Indians who are supporting Mr. Narendra Modi because they are quite tired of being time and again being fed a dream of an India which travels from half a roti to a full roti in 60 years, as Mr. Modi said in his speech today. The question that needs to be asked tonight is this, that if Rahul Gandhi is just a political office bearer of the Congress party and an MP and hence is briefed like every other politician, why is it that Rahul Gandhi on public platforms can incite communal tension and the Election Commission is not batting an eyelid?
Ms. Smriti Irani, Asifa Khan, Zafar Sareshwala, Hasan Kamal, Tanvir Sadiq and Shakti Singh, go ahead.
10 seconds, Arnab.
Sir,
Arnab, give me 10 seconds.
I thought that was the
give
last
me 10
one.
10 seconds, Arnab. Give me 10 seconds. Please.
I'm counting.
Please, 10 seconds.
I'm
then
counting.
Give me also 10 seconds. I will also leave to
this
reply.
Is very,
if you are, if you didn't allow anyone to speak and you want 10 seconds last and go away.
So what I'll do
like
is,
this?
No, what no, I'm going this, to do is, what I'm going to do is, no, we will seconds. Bring another no, debate in which Shakti Singh Gohil and Zafar Sareshwala can debate it out for no, more than 10
no,
seconds.
But
yes.
Only for tonight because I have more
Arnab,
disclosures.
Arnab, 30% Muslims have voted for BJP.
I have more.
And more than 200 Muslim delegations have met Mr.
What?
Gohil.
Who are talking? I have a data. Don't tell lies on
have,
channel.
What I
are
have you talking tonight. About?
Come with the data.
And you're telling me
I have to thank my guests for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.